Between 1885 and 1916, trains used the route shown with black. This route was not only steep, but prone to avalanches causing delays and sometimes deaths. And with so much rail traffic and twinning of that line not possible, Seoul began the huge task to tunnel a way through this area, creating the very first 8.1 kilometer Connaught Tunnel, opening in 1916, shown in yellow. At the time of opening, the Connaught Tunnel was the longest tunnel in North America and originally had two tracks running through it for both east and westbound trains. As time moved on in the early 1980s, it was clear that there was far too much rail traffic using this one tunnel, and due to the height restrictions, it had been reduced to one track for both directions. Something needed to be done. In 1984, work began on a brand new line, and this meant two new tunnels and a completely different route. This new route needed new bridges, a viaduct, and much more. So now eastbound trains would use this existing tunnel, and westbounds would use the new route. The new route heading up from Donald was 400 feet lower than the Connaught grade, making it much easier for trains to climb westbound. The first shorter tunnel passes through the east flank of the Shaughnessy Mountain and then under the highway, emerging here, and then crosses Bear Creek. The Shaughnessy Tunnel was completed in 1986. The sound you hear are the fans moving air through the tunnel. Fans were not originally installed in the Shaughnessy Tunnel, as it was thought it was short enough that it wasn't needed. However, locomotives climbing the grade were already hot from that, and the tunnel caused overheating in the summer, so they were installed in the mid-1990s. Macdonald Tunnel is by far the longest and most challenging tunnel in this project and will run 91 meters below the Connaught Tunnel through two entire mountains. At almost 15 kilometers long, it is the longest train tunnel in North America. Taking 4 years to build and an engineering marvel even for today's standard, it was the first time GPS was used to construct a tunnel of this size and was built from both ends simultaneously, meeting in the middle using two different methods. One, they used a tunnel boring mold, and two, they blasted just using traditional dynamite. This tunnel also has fans. However, they are special in that prior to ramping up to full speed, a door closes after the train entered. Once closed, the fans create enough air movement. It is equivalent to a hurricane force wind. The ventilation building, located mid tunnel, sits over 360 meters above the tunnel floor, seen below, and has four 2,250 horsepower fans, two exhaust and two supply. The shaft that includes an elevator is split in two and is 160 stories tall. The mid tunnel location also has a second door that will close after the train passes it to speed up the ventilation process. It will take the average train about 40 minutes to pass completely through the tunnel. As you can see in this photo, the tunnel is fully lined with cement and has lighting through the entire length. The Glacier Station, located at the entrance to the Connaught Tunnel on the west side, is in very poor condition and likely won't last much longer. Heavy snow and the lack of maintenance is showing on this 100-year-old historic building.